Hey guys, it's Michael from Cocker Chemistry. In this video, we'll be going over how to calculate the volume of the titrant that is needed to reach decoldence point. Let's take a look at the problem. 250 milliliters of 0.6 HBr is titrated with 0.75 molar LiOH. What volume of the titrant is needed to reach decoldence point? So just the two terms, analyte and titrant. Analyte is just what you're starting with, and then titrant is what you're adding. So our analyte here is the HBr, and then the titrant that the thing that we're adding to it is the LiOH. To solve for the volume of the titrant that's needed to reach equivalence point, we can just use the shortcut MaVa equals MbVb. Molarity of the acid times the volume of the acid equals molarity of base times volume of the base. Okay, let's plug it in. So the molarity of the acid, that's the 0.6 molar HBr. And I know this is acid because this has an H in the front. Bases usually will have an OH in it. The volume of the acid is 250 milliliters. It's okay to keep in milliliters. We don't have to convert this to liters. The molarity of the base is 0.75 molar. And then the volume of the base, that's what we're trying to solve for. That's VB. So to do this, we can just divide both sides by 0.75. So it'll be 0.6 times 250 divided by 0.75. And that gives us 200. So volume of the base that's needed is 200 milliliters, and that's the volume that's needed to reach the equivalence point. Taking a look at the graph, this is the equivalence point right here. It's right when you get, it's in the middle of that big spike. So it takes us 200 milliliters of base to reach that point. Next question. We have 50 milliliters of 1 molar H2SO4, and it's titrated with 0.8 molar NaOH. And this question is asking us what volume is needed to reach the first equivalence point and the second equivalence point. Because we have a diprotic acid, we have an acid that has two H's in it, and we're titrating it with just a base that has one OH, that means that we're going to get two equivalence points. So looking at the graph, it's going to look something like this, where that's the first equivalence point, and that's the second equivalence point. So to solve for the first equivalence point, we can just use the shortcut MaVa equals MbVb. The molarity of the acid is 1 molar. Again, we know this is the acid because it has an H in the front. The volume of the acid is 50 milliliters. The molarity of the base is 0.8 molar. And then the volume of the base, that's what we're trying to solve for. So to do this, we can just multiply 1 by 50 and then divide by the 0.8 so we can isolate the VB. And that gives us a volume of 62.5 milliliters. So 62.5 milliliters is the volume that's needed to reach the first equivalence point. And then to figure out the volume that's needed to reach the second equivalence point, we just have to take the original volume and multiply by 2. And that gives us 125 milliliters that's needed to reach the second equivalence point. And that's how you can calculate the volume of titrant needed to reach the equivalence point by using the equation MaVa, molarity of acid times volume of acid equals molarity base times volume of the base.
If you want to learn how to ace chemistry, if you want to learn what's the best way to study for this class, if you want to learn some neat tricks and tips to take into your exam and do better on them, then you should head over to my website and get this free guide, 12 Secrets to Acing Chemistry. You can head over to www.conquerchemistry.com/chemsecrets. I'm going to include a link in the description below. Check it out. I think it's really going to help you, and you're going to like it. Until next time, keep working hard and continue the good work.